There really is no place like home. Not if your hockey home is Montreal. The rink is draped with banners reminding you of a storied past, a place crammed with more than 21,000 critics and nearly as many ghosts. You get to tug on a familiar tricolored sweater, sometimes called La Sainte Flanelle, the Holy Flannel, without even a hint of irony. You are Jonathan Drouin. This season, no NHL player, certainly none who has changed teams, will face more scrutiny than you. In the fever dream of Canadiens fans, you are the next link of the rusting chain of homegrown French-Canadian stars. You know, the Rocket to Le Gros Bill, to the Flower, to Patrick. Other than your nice playoff run with the Lightning in 2015, you haven't sniffed a point-per-game average in three NHL seasons. You had 53 points last season. Of course, maybe 40 of those were coated in pixie dust, executed with a flair that has innate appeal in a city that appreciates the grace notes as much as the melody. You are an artiste.
Drouin will flip. He deeks, he backhands, he scores! That was magical! Wow!
Not every player wants to go home. Steven Stamkos chose to re-sign in Tampa Bay rather than cast his free agent lot with the Maple Leafs. But you want to be the big fish in one of hockey's grandest ponds. You cannonballed into the water after the trade last June. You shared a just-for-laughs stage with Max Pacioretty. You stole the show at the preseason golf tournament. You are a 22-year-old who likes the warmth of the spotlight on your face. You might help fix the forlorn Canadiens power play. You might even wind up as the number one center, although you haven't played the position since junior hockey. And if you, Monsieur Dangle, mollify those critics, exercise those ghosts, and make those classy blue-blanc-rouge uniforms something more than empty suits, you might get to ride in a parade. No pressure, Jonathan Drouin. No pressure.